Good morning, all of you. Let us take a look at a question from laws of motion. So there is a wedge of mass capital M and angle of inclination theta. So this is a wedge of mass M. Its angle of inclination is theta. There is another block of mass small m is arranged in a manner as shown. So this is a block here of mass small m, and it is placed on the wedge and it is connected to the wall through a rope as shown. The spring of force constant K is attached to the wedge. So we see there is a spring here, its force constant is K and it is attached to the wedge, and the other end is attached to the wall. So he is asking, find the compression of spring under equilibrium condition. In the diagram shown here, the spring that you see is in a relaxed state, and let us release this system and see how this system moves. Okay. Okay, you can see that this block pushes the wedge and the wedge starts moving towards left. And what happens is the spring also pushes the wedge in this direction. So when the net horizontal force on the wedge is balanced, the wedge comes to rest. So the diagram when the system is at rest is like this. Let us take the help of free body diagrams to solve this question. So one way of doing it is, you draw the free body diagram of only the wedge and draw the free body diagram of only this small block. Then write net force equals to zero in the x and y directions and solve it. A much easier method to solve it would be to take the free body diagram of the wedge plus the block here and only the small block separately. Let us write the forces on the wedge plus small block system. So the tension force due to string we have written as T towards left, right? And let us say X is the compression in the spring. So if X is compression in the spring will push the wedge towards right and with a magnitude Kx. M plus small m into G is the gravitational force on this whole system, and N is the normal reaction on the wedge due to ground. Next, let us look at the free body diagram of the smaller block. The gravitational force on the smaller block is small m into g. The string is pulling the block in this direction with the tension T. So we are writing tension T here. The wedge is in contact with this smaller block. So the wedge exerts a normal reaction force on the smaller block. Let us now write the equations for equilibrium condition for these two systems. So first, let us resolve the force mg. We know that the inclination angle is theta. So as this is 90 degrees, this will be 90 minus theta and this is theta. So mg can be resolved into two components, one along the incline and one perpendicular to the incline. So this component is mg sine theta, and this component is mg cos theta. So I'm taking along the incline as x axis and perpendicular to the incline here as y axis. So along the x axis, the t and mg sin theta are balanced. So we can write t minus mg sin theta equals to 0. Along the y axis, normal reaction balances mg cos theta. So we can write n minus mg cos theta equals to 0. For the wedge plus block, along x axis, the two forces acting are spring force kx and tension T. So we can write kx minus T equals to 0. And along y axis, normal and gravitational force are acting. So n minus m plus m into g equals to 0. Now I want you to observe and see the equations here. You see this equation is T minus mg sin theta equals to 0 and kx minus T equals to 0. If you eliminate T from both these equations, we will only have our variable as x. So we are writing kx equals to mg sin theta. Kx equals to mg sin theta, and from there x equals to mg sin theta by k. One more observation I want you to make here is, we had written the equations along the y-axis, okay? It is not required for us while solving this question. So with time and with practice, you will get to know only which equations to write and which equations you don't need to write.